pals, so today's video is going to be my tips on how to get a 36 on the math section of the ACT. Now, I thought I would make this video along with the other videos that I made on the other sections because I know that the ACT is fast approaching and it's becoming time for you juniors, if you're a junior watching this, to get a great score on the ACT, apply to that dream college, and get in. But that can't happen if you don't understand how the test works. And so that's what we're going to be talking about today for the math section. Now, for reference, I got a 33 on the math section and my boyfriend got a 36. These tips come directly from him, who got a 36, and me, who got a 33 on the math section. And I also was admitted to Harvard University under the Restrictive Early Action Decision Program, and I am attending, just so you know that about me. So if you want to see this video, make sure to give it a big like so that I know you liked it, and so that other people that could benefit from seeing this video can find it. Make sure to subscribe so that you don't miss my video on the science section, and then go back and find my English and reading videos if you need to see those. And without further ado, let's just jump right into it. So the first thing that I think is the most important to know about the ACT math section is that while you do have 60 questions, 60 minutes, you should not, and you honestly, unless you're a really, really a whiz at math, cannot just go, all right, 1 minute, one question. Because the questions in the beginning are vastly more easy than the ones at the end. And so it is recommended to do a 20-20-20 method, where the first 20 minutes you use to do your first 30 questions, because those are the easiest ones. And so don't take a lot of time checking those ones, just go through them, because they're a lot easier to do and you will lose valuable time. Then the next 20 questions, you use 20 minutes for those, and then the last 10 questions, you use 20 minutes for those. Often the more work you have to do, that applies to the later part of the test. Although it may be in your instinct to just 1 minute per each one question, by the end of the test you might realize, oh crap, I'm screwed because I have these problems. Oh, I need to do 3 steps to find that and I have 5 minutes. Oh my god, what do I do? So that's why the 20-20 method is really good. If you know how to do the question and you're doing it right, save your double checking until you've done every single question, because it is much better to probably have the answer right for all of them rather than have the first 45 definitely right and then have to guess on the last 15. I promise you, it's beneficial. Next, remember that you have a calculator and rely on it. Get yourself the best calculator that you can. I had the TI-84 Plus Color Edition. Figure out how it works. What formulas does it already have in it? Which programmed functions can it already do? What can you just plug in and then have it do the magic and the math for you without you having to use any brain power or any time to do it? Don't waste your time bringing a pencil and adding things. Just spend the $70 or however much it is to get a Texas Instruments TI-84 Color Edition Plus and use it. Look at the manual that comes with the calculator, go on YouTube, find videos on how to use it. Use it to your full potential, because you're not gonna get any more points if you add 3 plus 3 on paper and you get 6, or if you get 3 plus 3 and get 6 on your calculator. You're just gonna get more time, because 1 point is 1 point is 1 point. Just like the English section, math is more based upon knowledge than the reading or the science section, where you do need to have prior knowledge of how math works. So here are some formulas that you definitely need to know for the ACT math section. You need to know what point-slope form is, what's the distance formula, Pythagorean theorem, circle values such as area, circumference, equation to graph a circle, etc., quadratic formula, what's the discriminant. Those are the ones you definitely have to know, and if you go to the channel I will recommend at the end of this video, then there will be more formulas that you definitely need to know. Other tricky topics you have to understand is logarithms and trigonometric functions. You can't just guess through a lot of these questions. Okay, so next, and honestly probably the most important tip I can give you for the math section, is to understand what they're asking you. This is a common theme throughout all of the ACT, but it's especially important in math, because especially in the later parts of the test, you're going to be needing to do multiple steps to get the answer. And so what I recommend doing is read the question, underline specifically what answer you're looking for, and write down the information you have. So if the question is telling you have a 20-gallon bucket and a hose that fills up the bucket 1 gallon a minute, but there's a hole on the other side of the bucket that's emptying it at 1/2 gallon a minute, how full will the bucket be in 20 minutes? Okay, So then you would write down what you know, 20-gallon bucket, or you can circulate. You don't necessarily have to write it down. And then identify if there is any information that's put there to screw you over. So if that piece of information also included, next to it there is a 10-gallon bucket, blah, 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 blah. And the question is, how long will it take for the 20-gallon bucket to be filled up in 20 minutes? Then just cross out all the information about the 10-gallon bucket because it doesn't freaking matter and it will confuse you. So use your pencil, again, like I've been saying for all of these sections, underline and cross out things. And make sure you know what they're asking for, because if you just simply find out how long it would take the bucket to be filled without the hole that's leaking out the water at the end, then you're going to be like, oh, 20 minutes, perfect. Oh, 20 minutes is one of the answers, circle, move on. But that's not right, because then you have to figure out in that amount of time how much is coming out of the hole, and therefore what's the displacement that you're having to fill up again with the hose. But you would have missed that and gotten the question wrong because you just went, oh, 20 minutes, circle, move on. Make sure you do all the steps and know ahead of time what steps you need to do, because you're gonna get it wrong if you don't. Final tip is, I think, especially important for math, definitely, is to cross out and strike through the questions when you're done. I said this in my reading video, where you do question and you know you're right, so you strike through it. You cross out number 14, 16, or whatever it is, and then once you've gone through the entire page and you look and you see that all of your questions, you know that you have the right answer, or you have done it to the best of your ability and you're not going to check it again, you've crossed through those, then put a check mark at the bottom outer corner of the page, so that at the end, let's say you have 4 minutes left and you've gone through all the questions and you're like, okay, I have three that I put an answer down but I need to double check to see if I was right, or I have two that I didn't even know how to do, then you can just flip through really quickly, see the check marks, and save time finding the ones that you missed out on. This section, I definitely think you need to practice using mathematical formulas more than any of the other sections. You need to have a thorough knowledge of how math works, because otherwise you're not going to be able to just slip through this one. If you do need to try to guess, though, remember that in the ACT, oftentimes geometric figures are drawn to scale. So if the question is, how long is this altitude, and you absolutely do not know how to figure it out mathematically, if it says 6 and 8 and it's like a diagonal and you can be like, okay, that looks to be about 10 and the options are 12, 24, 18, and 17, well, then you know it's probably 12. Don't do it if you don't need it, but as a last resort, you can often use a kind of guess like that on the ACT if you need to. Okay, so those were my tips. I hope that they helped you. Another resource that I do recommend is Super Tutor TV. I will link their channel in the description below. They offer videos on the hardest types of questions to come across in the math, what formulas you need to know, as well as stuff for the common application, the other sections of the ACT, what activities to do to college, and more. So I definitely recommend that resource. And I hope this video helped you out. If it did, make sure to leave it in the comments below so that I know. Share this video with people that might need help on their math section. And subscribe so they don't miss my video on the science section of the ACT and how to get a 36 on that. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully I'll see you in the science video. Until then, ciao!